Welcome back to East Texas Live on KTK. We're joined now by Jennifer Pierman with A&M Agrilife. Thank you for joining us.
Glad to be here.
Yeah, so, you know, for those ladies at home or fellas, whoever isn't really into the sports aspect of the Super Bowl, but is definitely there for the food, like me, you've got a pretty handy recipe or some tips about how to make guacamole.
Yes, well, guacamole can be served anytime, yeah. In my opinion.
It's my favorite greens to eat.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. And this is a quick little recipe from the Dinner Tonight website. Zesty guacamole. It's avocados, garlic, onion, tomatoes, and pepper sauce. And you just kind of mix it all together, and it's a nice little lime juice in it.
Pepper sauce.
Yeah.
You just buy
like
that?
Tabasco or Louisiana hot sauce, whatever you
gotta
prefer.
Gotta have that kick.
So, yeah, yeah. And avocados are great. Fruit, vegetable, whatever, they are high in fat, which is the good fat, the mm-hmm. monounsaturated fats.
Not the McDonald's fat.
That's right. And the Centers for Disease Control, it provides a lot of nutrition from dietary fiber, from vitamins B, C, and E, magnesium, and folate, and potassium, and believe it or not, avocados have 60% more potassium per ounce than bananas do.
Really?
So, all the more reason.
Seriously,
to eat it.
I don't know, especially after a workout or something, I don't really want something sweet.
Yes.
So now you can just put some avocado toast or something.
And if you're getting ready for your Super Bowl and your avocados are a little green, a little tipped to ripen them, you can wrap them in foil and bake them in an oven on a 200 degree Fahrenheit oven for 15 minutes. Or if you've got a few days, you can put them in a brown paper bag with an apple and on your counter and just let them sit there for
the apple?
When the apple is ripening, it releases a certain kind of gas that helps ripen the other vegetables and fruit.
So when I've tried to make guacamole at home, which I don't do often because it never works, you know, it's never smooth. You know, it kind of comes out in chunks. Do you have any tips for that?
Elbow grease.
I just need to lift a little bit more, I guess.
Just sit there and mash and mash until you get it. But also remember to eat it within a couple of hours. If, like for the Super Bowl, if you're having a buffet or whatever, a couple of hours on the table is all you needed. If not, bacteria can start to grow, but it never lasts that long at my house.
Seriously, I'm always like, oh, I'll have some now, and then maybe some for before dinner, and then it never makes it.
That's it.
We won't see the second half. So for more information, where can people find that?
They can find information on the Dinner Tonight website, which is dinnertonight.tamu.edu.
All right, Jennifer, thank you so much.